So you see me talking about toxic oils and how it is unsafe to use them in your cooking or even to have them in your foods. So there's this new thing come out, and we've been seeing it for a little while now, but it's starting to really take over, and that is high oleic oils. So are they safe or are they dangerous? Are they better for us than these toxic oils that I talk about, or are they actually safe for us to use? Okay, so for those of you who don't know me, my name is Belinda, and I'm very passionate about helping women take control of their own health. So maybe you have sleeping issues, maybe you have energy issues, maybe you've been told you have a thyroid problem, or maybe you're suffering from autoimmune conditions, whether it be joint or skin problems or things like this. This is something that I actually deal with a lot and help women with all the time. So anyway, back to our topic today, which is high oleic oils. Now, you hear me talking about toxic oils, such as canola oils and soybean oils and vegetable oils, which does not contain vegetables, and how these actually mess with our hormones. And when you actually delve into it, you will find that these are literally in everything prepackaged. I'm talking from biscuits to breads to, you know, you would think that your olives or your sun-dried tomatoes would be in olive oil, but guess what? They're not. Well, some of them are. If you're lucky, you can find them. But most often, they are going to be in these toxic oils, okay? In these vegetable oils or rapeseed oils, okay? And at the moment, there's been a big push to improve the quality of these oils. Okay, and that's why they're starting to bring out high oleic oils. And the belief is that we're taking the good part from these oils, from these bad oils, and just using the good part and getting rid of the toxic part. But is that actually the case? Well, I was just looking at a study that was done on mice. Okay, so yes, it's not humans, it's mice, and it may or may not translate very well for humans. But this study had done a study on saturated fats like coconut oil. It had done it with soybean oil, which is high hydrogenated, so a toxic oil. And they had also done one with soybean oil on high oleic. Okay, now the interesting thing about this was that the health of the mice were actually best on the saturated coconut oil. Okay, so what can we take away from this? The mouse with the hydrogenated oil, which is the soybean oil, actually came out with fatty liver and a few other things. And I think the one with high oleic oil was slightly healthier than the one with the full soybean oil, okay? So, and like I said, this may not translate very well for humans, but my instincts tell me, just stay away from them, okay? It's not good for you. It messes with your hormones and can cause very devastating health effects down the line, okay? Cheap and nasty is literally just that, okay? You know, your canola oils and vegetable oils and things like that, yes, they're cheap, but do you want your health to be cheap? No, you want to look after your health. Health really is wealth. So a great book to look at if you are interested in looking at more of this is a book called Toxic Oil by David Gillespie. And I highly recommend just taking a couple of hours. Even just reading the first page is a huge eye-opener. Anyway, so that's my take on this. Stick to your healthy oils. Anyway, let me know what healthy oils you're using. Are you using an avocado oil or a coconut oil or an olive oil? Or what healthy oils are you using at this moment? Anyway, if you're catching this live, then say live down below. And if you catch it on the replay, then let me know. Talk to you then. Bye.